You are the segue.
Hello, mate. I should have said, hello, me.
Well, of course.
As a student leaving university, a job interview can be quite a scary prospect, which is why I'm here at Loughborough University to give their students a helping hand in some of the questions that can be asked during a job interview. I'm Max Fosh, and welcome to StreetSmart. What are you thinking about doing after uni? What's the plan?
Well, I've got a job.
Job, congratulations.
Thanks.
In what?
Events management.
Events management, that's exciting. These are real questions that have been asked in interviews before. They're very odd.
I've got a placement lined up because of my interview.
So you should be good at these.
Quite good at these.
What are you doing, Max?
This is my job.
Good job.
Yeah.
Unlucky Max.
Yeah. But I think they're designed to try and show how you think as someone who works in the...
I don't think.
Do you guys... at least you're honest. First question, why are manhole covers round?
So a man can get down them.
No, heads around, they're not square.
But you're not really going head first into a manhole, are you?
Yeah, I know, but you're like hips are like...
head's got to get through at some point.
At some point.
What?
Manhole covers. You know, a manhole, stuff in the ground that you access the sewer with.
Oh, I see. Alright, cool.
Yeah. I didn't think I'd have to explain this, but a manhole is the thing in the road that goes down to the sewer. Second bit of the question, why are they round?
If that was asked in an interview, I'd probably walk out, to be honest.
Just have the round thing in their thing, because men have to...
You're not being quite as coherent as you think you are.
Dad bod's in that, yeah.
Yeah, I agree, mate.
Yeah, good answer, mate. Yeah,
good answer. Good answer. What was the last gift you gave?
Your birthday present.
What was it?
Eyeshadow. It was an eyeshadow.
You wearing it?
It was to my ex, can't lie. It was box chocolates and...
That's probably why she's your ex.
You bought you some, I can't remember what it was now.
You did not. Wedding never bought me anything.
Oh, what are your necklace for Christmas? You're wearing it now.
Christmas was the last time you gave a gift.
I went to an engagement car party, right, and I gave like a little like countdown that was like days to our wedding.
It's going to be really useful to ask for the wedding as well.
And a DVD?
Who else is it? Hermione Ron.
DVD?
DVD.
Hi, 2009 call. They want their present back.
I bought you food. That's a gift.
Why are tennis balls fuzzy?
Oh, I know this!
You can hold them nicely and they feel like a soft little gerbil. No?
They do often get them mixed up, to be fair, at Wimbledon.
Friction!
Friction.
It's got to be something to do with grip and like aerodynamics, hasn't it?
Yeah, gotta be.
When they hit the grass, then they can bounce off in any direction. I don't know. I don't play tennis.
I play tennis.
This explains why I've got a job and you two haven't.
Well, because they feel nice. Mm. Is that actually it?
No. How lucky are you?
I think I'm pretty lucky.
I'll find out tonight.
Wonderful. Good luck.
I'm very lucky because I've met these lovely people and I love them so much. I'm so cringe.
I'm pretty lucky. To be here, look around us. To be here, pretty lucky.
I can't see it.
My dad looks a bit like Michael Gove.
A lot like Michael Gove.
Is your dad Michael Gove?
No. Michael Gove exclusively.
How much would you charge to clean every window in Loughborough?
Let's take into account mathematics first.
Yeah.
That wouldn't be that hard. Get your bucket and your ladder.
You need a squeegee.
7 halls. What about 1,000 halls per window?
Have you seen how many there are? Towers! Tall.
3 window, how much would you charge?
£10 a window.
About £70,000.
Student loan at least.
Yeah. I ain't got a grad job, I'll do it.
Name 5 uses for a stapler when you don't have any staples.
Right, you take 2, I'll take 4. Wait, hang on. So, number 1, flicking it like a butterfly knife, but if you can't afford a butterfly knife, stapler.
It's a Ryman's.
You could use the side as a ruler.
Right, 1.
To whack someone, because obviously any blunt object, you can whack someone.
Yep.
Number 3, for the spring, you take the spring out, do whatever you want with the spring.
So I'll go for step 1, a paperweight.
Wait, right.
Thinking outside the box?
To staple your course foot together.
Again, no staple.
Stressful.
Number 4, if you found some staples, you could use the stapler gun.
Yep.
Straight in your hair.
Yes, you could! With staple marks, that would look sexy.
I think that's how crimping. Like,
climb a tree. You can climb a tree without a staple. Mm. Yeah.
Yep.
Yes. Yeah, up to you guys. Whoever's watching, you can choose number 5.
Welcome to StreetSmart. I'm Max Fosh, and welcome to StreetSmart. Yeah!